Let's talk about melanoma brain metastases. A very big problem, and all of a sudden there seems to be light at the end of the tunnel, right? Mm-hmm. So I'll start with you, Caroline, in terms of, let's talk about the immunotherapy data with combination therapy, which has looked exciting for a while.
Yes, so it's good data, but I would like to remind everybody that it's a very selected population of patients.
The CheckMate 204 we're talking about, asymptomatic brain mets.
Asymptomatic. That's right. Less than three, I mean, three maximum.
Very selected.
These are good patients, and this is not the majority of our patients. So it's very good. We are very happy to see this response rate, and definitely the combination really achieved a very good result. But this is not the majority of our patients, and also there is a caveat that we are not, we have not evaluated the combination or the sequence with the radiosurgery, which we use a lot, which is very effective when we have a metastasis that we can treat with radiosurgery. And today, in our everyday practice, we discuss all the patients with our tumor board, neuro-tumor board, and we initiate systemic treatment. And also, we also treat with radiosurgery, but we need to have some kind of control study to know if it's better to do it upfront or to do it later on, and which
we do the same thing at our center. Every patient is evaluated by a multidisciplinary team, includes a neurosurgeon, radiation oncologist, medical oncologist. Dirk, we had a big debate about BRAF positive patients in the systemic melanoma setting, and adjuvant as well. But in brain mets, do you have a different approach to a BRAF positive patient? Let's start with a very specific question. Asymptomatic patient with BRAF-positive disease, brain metastases, would you go with the combination immunotherapy or would you go with targeted therapy for that patient based on all the data we have, which is not randomized, of course?
Yeah, no, I think for asymptomatic patients, I think our approach would also be stereotactic gamma knife radiation and checkpoint blockade, definitely.
Combination, yeah.
So that the issue, which I think one has to keep in mind also with the CheckMate 204 data, that stereotactic radiation has a response rate of 100%. The duration of the response might be different, and that needs to be shown. And we need to work out the combination of radiation, as Caroline said, between radiation and long-lasting control. And that's the issue with targeted therapy. I mean, we have seen that we are getting responses, so we are using targeted therapy, BRAF-MEK combinations, particularly in symptomatic patients where we need an immediate, quick onset of the
You're
response.
You're talking about brain met symptomatic?
Yes.
In fact, the response rate in the brain met is 50%, but it's not as durable.
Exactly.
It seems not to be as durable.
Yeah, but I mean, if you have a symptomatic brain met, I think it's much quicker. And then the question is, can you complement this kind of treatment with checkpoint? Can you stabilize that? So I think that's could also be an area which is not explored, but an area for triplet therapies quickly, because you have the quick onset of the therapy of the targeted component, and then hopefully the long-lasting stabilization effect. But I think that needs to be shown.
So do you switch with someone who is symptomatic, BRAF-positive disease, give them targeted therapy, make them asymptomatic, and then switch them?
No, I would not switch without progression today without a clinical trial, because the patient is doing well. You switch, it's the catastrophe. So what do you tell the patients? Yeah. If it's not in a clinical trial, I would not do it.
I mean, it's only for the durability question, but it's not known.
Yeah, we would probably, in a few patients where we have urgent need, we would possibly off-label, we would combine already now.
Really? That's, of course, something that's being researched in, of course, systemic disease, triple combinations. Can I ask you, Caroline, we talked a lot about combination immunotherapy. What about monotherapy? There was an ASCO update also for monotherapy, pembrolizumab, for brain metastases. Are there any patients that are BRAF wild type, so you don't have a choice of BRAF therapy, that you would choose monotherapy for brain metastases instead of combination?
Well, first, it depends on the availability of the combination.
And assuming you have everything.
So imagine you have everything, depends on the comorbidity. If you have a patient that you think can stand the combination, you would offer the combination. If you have a fragile patient, you would give the monotherapy. Plus radiosurgery, we had a lot of patients where when we didn't have access to the combination of immunotherapy, a lot of patients were treated with anti-PD-1 single agent plus radiosurgery and did really well. So not in a controlled way, but we had a lot of patients treated like that. Long-term responses.
What is your experience? I mean, there is some rumor on radionecrosis of combining checkpoint blockade and...
We looked at that. We published that last year, and we found that there was no the same rate of radionecrosis where we, when we had PD-1 monotherapy, anti-PD-1, it was nivo-pembro plus radiosurgery, we did not find more radionecrosis than with radiotherapy only.
And whole brain and checkpoint blockade, you don't do at all?
We don't do it at the same time. We try to sequence.
So while we're talking about whole brain, there was an interesting trial presented at ASCO, wasn't there? A randomized trial of whole brain radiation therapy seemed to imply that we should no longer ever do that.
No.
What are your thoughts, Dirk, on that? And then
no,
Lex?
I think we have stopped doing whole brain radiation.
We did not wait for the result of this trial.
Yeah, we all stopped doing it a while ago. In fact, it's very interesting in my clinic,
in
the
fact,
radiation oncologists don't want to do it.
So, in fact, no, it's not very, very true for us. We do it sometimes when it's almost lost.
When there's nothing else left.
Yeah. And sometimes you have good surprise. Or you don't know if it's because of that, but it seems that... Honestly, we do it sometimes, maybe once every 3 months we have a patient who is... We really have full of brain metastases, and it goes or it doesn't go through, but we do it sometimes, and we have some survivors, but it's very rare.
Randomized trial was in 1 to 3 melanoma brain metastases, which is very interesting, very similar to the CheckMate trial.
Yeah.
Lex, at your center, radiation therapy, not counting stereotactic, whole brain, not done, considered. Last resort.
So Caroline will answer that question because we're from the same center.
Yeah.
Right.
So I would like to avoid contradicting Caroline because otherwise I may be in big trouble.
The thing is, what I'm very surprised to see, I would like to know what you think about that. I'm surprised to see some very good outcome of re-challenging with anti-BRAF, anti-MEK, even in very difficult situation, mm-hmm. after a first response, then a relapse, immunotherapy, and then re-challenging. I'm very surprised by some very long good outcome in these patients.